Hello everyone, welcome to the session to learn about the milestones in growth and development in the age group of 0 to 5 years. Today we have the expert Mrs. Madhur Bhatia, who will explain the physical development and the motor development for the age group of 0 to 5 years. Over to Mrs. Madhur Bhatia.
Thank you, madam. Dear students, you must have noticed that newborns cannot sit without support, but 4 months old infants are able to sit with support for a minute, and by 9 months, most infants can sit without support for 10 minutes and even longer. Similarly, during toddlerhood years, that is 1 to 3 years, there is a marked transition in children where children grow and attain a number of developmental milestones. This makes us wonder how such rapid growth takes place in young children. In addition to that, how do children in a similar age group go through similar changes? In each stage of development, one can expect certain competencies to appear in every domain of development. These are called developmental milestones. Milestones of development present the age ranges during which the majority of infants and toddlers accomplish each skill. But no two individuals are alike, and each child is a unique individual. One child may start speaking early and other might take more time to speak. Therefore, one must note that although the sequence of development is fairly uniform, predetermined and common to all children, however, individual differences exist in the rate at which development proceeds. Since now we have understood what are milestones of development, now I'll be discussing with you the milestones of development from 0 to 5 years of age. First domain of development we are talking about is physical development, that is development in the physical body. Now the milestones in physical development. We all know that there is a rapid growth in infancy and early childhood period. Some developmental features are inherited. However, environment plays an important role in giving a final shape. As you see in the picture, that the curve is upward. A child grows very rapidly during the infancy and the early childhood period and is impacted by the different domains of development as we have already discussed. Now, when we talk about the physical growth, that is, normal weight should increase in the first year of life. When we talk about the birth weight, it is at around 2 to 3.5 kg, which doubles around, that is, the birth weight doubles around by 6 months and it triples around by the child is 1 year of age. There are also physical growth in length. At birth, the child is nearly about 40 to 50 centimeter in length, as you see in the picture. And it is about 1.5 times of birth length by the child is 1 year of age. The picture clearly shows you the difference when at the birth and when the child is at 1 year of age. Similarly, there are changes in body proportion. The pictures clearly indicates that there are changes in head circumference, arm circumference and chest circumference. That is, circumferences are good indicators of the level of nutrition and growth. What kind of nutrition you have provided to the child, how the growth pattern develops, that impacts how the child develops. Similarly, body proportion changes with age of growth and development. Now you see in the first picture of the child, the head of the child is bigger and gradually you see it gets down to smaller. So there are changes in the body proportions overall. The baby gains control over muscles in the trunk and the back first. The baby gains control over muscles in the arms. The baby gains control over muscles in the fingers then. And the muscles of neck and shoulder develops before the baby can sit. Now, in the picture, you can see that there's a transition. First, the child was only able to lie down and then slowly and slowly develop his or her muscles and then gradually takes control over the muscles in the fingers and the muscles of the neck and shoulder develops before the body, baby can sit. So this is how the development proceeds. Now you see that the trunk must be strong before the baby can stand. Similarly, as I've talked to you about the development in the body dimensions, body proportions and the height and the weight, there are development in the primary teeth also. Now, I'll be discussing with you about the development of primary teeth. By 5 to 6 months of age, two teeth erupt in the lower jaw first, as the picture clearly shows you that. By 3 years of age, full set of 20 teeth, that is 10 upper jaw plus 10 lower jaw, develops, and by the child is 6 to 7 years of age, milk teeth are replaced by permanent teeth. So this is really very important for us to understand how the development of primary teeth take place in the overall development of the child. Now we will talk about the development of muscles. Let's take first at birth. What happens at birth? At birth, bones are very soft as they contain more cartilage, and that is the reason why when children fall, they rarely fracture their bones. This is the basic reason. And now when we talk about the growing child, bones are hardened due to deposition of calcium. Process of hardening is called ossification, and it's really a very continuous process. Children's bones are covered with fat and muscles. So in early years, fat deposit is more than muscles. With age, muscles are more. So this is how the process of development of muscles takes place. This is just about how the physical development of a child takes place. Now I will discuss with you about the motor development. As seen in the picture, the child is quite active and trying his level best to come down from the stairs. So let's see how the motor development of the child takes place. Motor development. What is motor development? It refers to the changes in child's ability to control the movement of the body. Motor skills include, for example, learning to sit, learning to walk, learning to kick, learning to hold, learning to tricycle. So these are when the child is really active and employing all the muscles in the day-to-day activities. There are two types of motor development. When we talk about the types of motor development, there are two types of motor development. One is gross motor skills and the other is fine motor skills. Gross motor skills, movements involving large muscles like those in arms, legs, feet or the entire body. For example, which is used for walking, jumping and so on. So large muscles are used for performing all these kinds of activity which I have talked about, like walking, jumping and so on. The other is fine motor skills, which involves smaller muscles like those in hands, wrists and fingers, which is used for holding a crayon or toy or painting or scribbling or drawing. So both the motor skills lead to the complete motor development of the child. Now see the motor development at the age of 0 to 2 months. And this is a very crucial stage. We have to be really very careful how the motor development takes place in this age group. Here, the child kicks aimlessly, stretches hand and feet and have close fist. At the age of 2 to 4 months, you will find a little more development in the motor development activities of the child. He or she stares at bright object, lifts chest short, distance holding head, rolls from back to the side and begins to grasp toy in the hand. So you will see in the picture also the child is trying his or her level best to perform different activities. Now look at ages 4 to 6 months. You will see more the previous development which I discussed with you. You will see more mature development in the child 4 to 6 months. He or she is able to hold head steady, holds toys, raises hands to be lifted, lifts self by hands or forearms when lying on the stomach and sits up when propped. Similarly, 6 to 8 months. I should repeat here that this is a very crucial stage of development and we should learn how the child's motor development takes place in these ages. So, during the 6 to 8 months, the child can hold head and sit erect without support, can pick up objects from floor, table. He has now the picking ability. He can pick up the objects, can use the thumb to grip things, to hold anything. Now, he has a gripping power too. Now let's see the motor development of the child from 8 to 10 months. The child begins to crawl, can pull self to stand by holding on to furniture, hold small objects, for example, spoon between thumb and finger, and can hold, bite and chew objects. Now are you noticing that the transition from birth till 10 months of age? So this is how we learn, this is how the child grows, and this is really very important for us to understand. Now 10 to 12 months. You see in the picture, the child is able to stand with slight support, walks with support, can push light objects, picks up small and big objects and examines them. Here, a little kind of curiosity also develops to explore the objects. Now, 1 to 2 years. The child is able to walk without support, drinks from a cup, plays with push and pull toys, can climb stairs and come down as well, and scribbles with pen and pencil, and can eat by self. So these are the developmental phases when the child is between 1 to 2 years of age. And as being students, we can observe this development and can relate to these milestones, how the child is developing. And if this kind of development is delayed, we can immediately provide an intervention to the child so that he or she can develop to its optimum potential. Now let's see the development from 2 to 3 years. Now the child has grown up, he or she can play tirelessly, can feed himself well. He or she will not now depend on you to feed, and you should provide an opportunity to let him feed himself or herself. Can acquire bowel and bladder control, can brush hair and teeth, and follow simple instructions. If you are giving simple instruction, go there, come here, he or she can easily follow. And our duty is to provide opportunities to the child so that he or she can be independent enough. Now 3 to 5 years, you will find many more advanced stages of development here. Now can button and unbutton, can dress without help, can attend to personal needs like brushing teeth, and can be ready for school. The child at this period of time has a little understanding of the daily routines and activities. Till now we have come to know that development is a continuous process, and there are individual differences. Every child is unique, but there are certain milestones in the process of development. I have discussed with you the milestones of physical development. Now I will be discussing with you the milestones in social emotional development. First, we should understand what is the meaning of social emotional development. You must have seen that at birth, the child is neither social or unsocial. But with age, the child develops and learns to experience, express, and manage the emotions. Develop social skills to get along with others. Other means parents, other family members, peer group. He or she establishes relationship with others and show the repulsion when uncomfortable. So this is the broader meaning of the socio-emotional development, and at different stages of a child's life, this aspect of the domain of development should be taken care of well. Now if I talk about birth to 6 months, you can see in the picture the child is enjoying. Now let's see how he's showing his expressions. As we are talking about socio-emotional development, we have to focus on the emotions and how he gets along with others in the group. He or she gives warm smiles and laughs, responds to touch and sound, cries when upset to seek comfort, and shows excitement by waving arms and legs. Later we will comparing this kind of activity, and when the child is about 5 years of age, you will see marked transition in the socio-emotional development of the child. And then we can relate to when we discussed about the individual differences, that development is a continuous process, development is a product of maturation and learning. So all those principles of development we can apply here. So milestones are formed according to that. 6 to 12 months of child, he or she expresses different emotions clearly, cries or irritate on removing a favorable article or activity. If you have removed, the child likes some kind of activity or any kind of toy, he or she gets irritated, responds to your gestures, the kind of gestures you show. For example, if you are showing an angry face, the child will guess it. If you are showing a happy face, the child will really guess it. So we have to be really responsive to what the child is responding to. Can differentiate between familiar and strangers. The child is very much attached to his or her parents. So he can differentiate, or she can differentiate, between familiar faces and the strangers. Now see the development from 1 to 2 years of age. This is a grown-up stage. So the child is able to recognize self in the mirror, a photo, imitates adult's action. So this is really very interesting to know also. Hugs and kiss familiar people and pets, play next to other child, may show frustration and tantrums. Now 2 to 3 years, shows awareness of feelings of self and others. The child is now very much self-aware. He or she knows about his or her own feelings and the feelings of the others. If I'm happy, he or she can recognize, yeah, my mother is happy. Or if I'm upset, he or she has the ability to recognize, yeah, that my mother is upset. So he or she is very much aware of the feelings of self and others. Shows fears in certain situations, may become shy or start cry loud. Wants independence, but still needs security of parents, because at this time, autonomy starts. So he or she wants independence, but then under the security of the parents or the guardian. Displays happiness. Now come to 3 to 5 years of age. You can see in the picture, the children are getting along with others and are really grown up. So during this age, you will find marked transition from what we have learned from 0 to 1 year of age. Here, develops friendships and shares toys and plays simple games with rules and feel happy on winning. Feel happy on new clothes, food belonging to them, and resist on activity they don't like. So they have their own rules, they know their choices, they know what the kind of activities they want to play. So, and they develop friendships and they really trust them. So this is the kind of development, socio-emotional development in the age group of 3 to 5 years. Now comes the language development. All domains of development lies on language development. Language development is really important. Without language development, the child would not be able to express himself or herself, will not be able to tell what he or she needs. So, language development is a very important domain of development in the process of development. Let's understand what's language development. Language development is the child's ability to communicate, express and understand feelings, think, solve problems and imagine, develop and maintain relationships, learn to understand, use language for literacy. So this is all about language development, which lies upon how to communicate, express and understand feelings. Because communication, what is communication then? Communication is that the other person is able to understand what I'm trying to express, and on the other hand, I'm able to understand what he or she is trying to explain. So it's a two-way process of interaction. Now you see the picture of the child. It's a very young child. In the language development during this phase, it involves cooing, babbling, crying, responding to voices and sounds, and able to convey the basic needs of the body like hunger. If the child is hungry, he or she will cry loud. So this is the major language development during this period of time. Now when we see about 6 to 12 months of the child, as seen in the picture, the child is able to say one word speech like ma, pinpoint body parts and pictures, objects and identifying by your voice. He or she can identify if you're calling and making sound to attract attention. Now look at 1 to 2 years of age. A beautifully shown picture you see here on the left hand side, speak meaningful one word, responds to his name, responds to friendly or angry tone. You have an angry tone, the child will respond accordingly. He or she might cry. So this is a kind of language development and transition from that part of the life to 1 to 2 years of age. And 2 to 3 years of age, speak meaningful 2 to 3 words, repeat words or sentence frequently for no reason, and enjoys music, stories. At this time, children enjoy storytelling. You can provide lots many opportunities for the child for the language development during this phase of the life. Now you see vocabulary keep increasing rapidly, express emotions through words or gesture. For example, I'm not happy, I don't like this, I don't want to play with this friend of mine, I don't like you, you all, I like this, I want butter bread, or I want to play with my friends. They can express their emotions through words or their gestures. Speak small stories, poems, rhymes, etc. and use grammar in framing sentences. They now understand the language easily and they apply the principles of language in their day-to-day conversation with others. Now see the 5 years of a child. Here the vocabulary keep increasing, like more than 500 words a child can know up till this years of age and use adult like language, can speak confidently in class or in front of others. So a kind of independency in expressing emotions and in expressing the language, what kind of sentences a child wants to use. So all those things develop during this period of time. Now one more important domain of development is cognitive development. Cognitive development is related to thinking and acting part. Let's see the cognitive development from birth to 2 years. The child realizes the existence of the self and caregiver, unable to think logically. I would like to re-emphasize here because I am discussing the development from birth to 2 years. Here the child is unable to think logically, believes that all living and non-living things possesses life and feelings. Now let's see the development from 2 to 3 years. You can see in the picture, it is a very expressive picture. The child indulges in fantasy and make-believe play, easily confused by surface appearances, has uneven attention and has limited memory. Now 4 to 5 years, the child acquires basic concepts of color, shape, size, number, days, etc. Has high level of curiosity. Curiosity develops at this age. The child is very curious. He or she wants to know the environment, the things around. So we need to provide the opportunity to the child to explore the environment, to quench his or her curiosity. And at this age, the child is confused about casual relationships. So this was all about the cognitive development of the child from 1 to 5 years of age. You must have seen the transition, how the child's cognitive development takes place from illogical thinking to logical thinking. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, madam. You have explained all the milestones in a very nice, subtle manner. All the physical development, motor development, socio-emotional development and the cognitive development. Thank you once again.